Now in this video, I will show you how to extract the total number of records according to the range of age. So this is 0 to 5 years old, 6 to 12. So we will extract how many person belong to this corresponding range of age. So we will take this data from table residence with the birth date field, this one. So we will extract that one using our query, and this is the result: range plus how many person belong to this range. Okay, let's start. First, we need to go to create, then query design. So we'll just close this one, then go to design, then click this one. Automatically it will show us the SQL editor. Now there is a default which is select. We will delete this semicolon and we will put some alias. We type open bracket, then zero and five. So 0 and 5. So this is our the age range. Now we will use this statement switch. So instead of this one will appear 0 to 5, we'll put here text 0 to 5 years old. So that's the function of switch. So instead of this age will show, this will show this one is 0 5 years old 6. So from the age it will switch to this text. That's why we are using switch. So we have 0 to 5 range, then this is the data or text shown, then followed by comma, then we'll go down again, we'll type age, then close bracket. Next is 6 to 12. So again we'll use between 6 and 12, then comma. Now this switch text, which is 0 6 to 12. Why I put years old? Why I put 0 not only 6? Because as you can see here, if I put only 6 instead of 0 6, automatically this 6 will goes down because this is ascending order. So meaning if I put here 6 only without the 0, since this is the text, so this 6 to 12 it will goes here because this is ascending. If I put 0 here, 0 6 of course this is the order, 0 then 0 6 13 18. That's why I put here 0 instead of 6 only. Again, double quote, then followed by comma, then we will go to the next range, which is 13, 17. So again, age between 13 and 17, comma. Now we will switch to 13 to 17 years old. Double quote, then comma, then we'll proceed to another range, which is 1835. So again, age between 18 and 35, then we will switch to 18 to 35 years old. I forgot to put here old. I'm too old. Then double quote followed by comma, then cursor down. Next is age, then another age range, which is 36 to 50. So between 36 and 50, we will switch to 36 to 50 years old. Then double quote, again comma, then next age of brains, 36, 50, 51, 65, between 51 and 65, then we will switch to 51 to 65 years old, double quote, then comma, then another range, which is only the 65 above. So I will put here age instead of between. Now I will put more than 66 because this is our last age range. So more than 66, comma, then we'll switch to above 66. Okay, now we will close because we already done the whole age range. Then as age group, so this is the age group. So we will count this one, each group, we will count as total for this one. Now, from where we get this age? So of course, we need to extract from our table and this birth date field. So we will use the date def function or the date deference. Okay, so I will type from, then select date def, then we have 5 arguments on the def. Okay, now we'll put the interval which is the year. So I will put here 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is the year, double quote, then comma, and now our field, which is the birth, this one. This is our field. We need to copy here, close bracket, then comma, then the date too. So this is the date which is we compare the difference between our birth date and the current date. So now I will put date, then so the current date, then we will close that one, then less, I will put this one F format, then we'll use this date followed by comma. The next is the format date, then the first week of the year. So I will put month, day, in double quote, then close parenthesis, this more than, again I will take our double quote, then format for our birth, copy birth date, close bracket, then again month, day, then we'll close, we'll put this one, then zero. Now we will close. So this is the one as age. So this is the one age between 6 to 12, then we will switch to 6. So this, the source of this age is coming from this, from this date difference. Then of course we need to put our from what table. So I will select this one, press F2, then I will copy from residence, just to make sure that our table is correct. Then we'll close parenthesis, then as, now we will use this alias, this one. Here we'll copy residence, then close bracket, then close parenthesis, then as alias. Then I will move down. Now we will make a grouping. So group by alias dot age group. Age is the one. Age group, we will count. Age group, wrong spelling. Then order by, again we'll just copy this alias, then close bracket, then each group. Now we'll put at the end colon or semicolon rather. So this is the one. This is the whole SELEC statement or the SQL in order to achieve this age range from our table according to the corresponding birth date. Okay, now we will save age range count, then I will put QRY, then hit OK. Name bracket, we have some error here, invalid bracket here. Okay, there is an error because I forgot to put here the close bracket. Okay, now we will save. This is the one, sorry for inconvenience, this is the one. I hope everything is fine. Okay, look, this is the age range. Now let's open our query. Look, this is the result. Okay, again I will show you the this is our query. Then if we will run, and this is the result. So now we can use this one into our dashboard. Okay, so just go to create or design rather, then you can select what you want. So I will use the list box, this one. So that's our source query, all now we open. So this is our age range and the total count. I will just adjust here at least 2.5. So this is it. This is how to extract the total number of records each range of age from our date of birth using our switch statement. It will give us, instead of the specific age, it's showing only the age range, which is we switch from the years or rather or age. Okay, thank you and God bless.